Welcome to another episode in our Unlocking Church series. Today, all about why should we read the Bible? For many, the Bible is just an uninspiring, boring, dull, difficult to read book. But what if I were to tell you that the Bible is still the number one best-selling and most widely distributed book in the whole of the world? It comes in many different shapes and formats and different translations and different thicknesses, sometimes with rhymes and pictures, but more often with just lines and lots of words. In fact, the Bible has more than 611,000 words. It's longer than War and Peace, 35% longer than the whole of the Lord of the Rings trilogy. It's been written over a period of 1,500 years in three different languages by more than 40 different authors who belong to royalty, but also were some simple fisherman, farmer, a tent maker, a homeless prophet, a doctor, a physician, a professional scribe, church leaders and musicians. It has been carefully edited and copied down and compiled over thousands of years. And yet when we compare very early copies from the first century and what we can read today in our Bibles, we find out they are almost identical. What we read in our Bibles today is exactly what people thought about and experienced in and around the life of Jesus. This book is an absolute masterpiece, but it's more than that. It is the Word of God. I believe that this book has been written by people like you and me who were really just experiencing God's goodness and God's graciousness in their lives. As they reflect his beauty, his nature, as they live out his love to others as image bearers. But despite this book being 66 different parts, it has an incredible overarching storyline that shows us that God loves humanity more than anything else. In fact, when we look at the first part of the Bible, in this first book called Genesis, we read that God has created humans to be in his presence forever. Yet we know Adam and Eve, they decided to walk away because they had the choice to follow God or do it all on their own. Yet God never decided to leave them on their own. For the rest of the book, we can read how God continually draws close to people. He enters into agreements with them, even though he knows that by the next day they will have broken that one already. He rescues them out of slavery, even though they were worshipping other gods. He sent prophets and kings to them so that they could tell the Israelites more about who God was. Yet more often than not, they were just not interested. And so we end up in the New Testament where we can read that God even sent his own son to die on the cross. Jesus died so that we can have that relationship with God that's beyond this world. That's what this book is all about. It's a story about how we as people can encounter this God who is all-loving, who is just, who is patient and compassionate, who's gracious, who's slow to anger, abounding in love and faithfulness. So why should we read the Bible? Well, because it introduces us to God. It can be a tool of encouragement, but more than anything else, it can be a way of hearing God's voice in our lives, of letting God speak to us. It's a way of knowing God deeply, not just in our heart, but also in our minds as we read those difficult and challenging passages. Because I can tell you straight away that reading the Bible is not going to be easy. It's a really old book, which means there will be passages that are difficult to understand. There'll be passages that raise some really uncomfortable questions. And there'll be passages that will simply, I don't know, send you to sleep because on the surface level, they are just so boring. But I believe that as we power through those obstacles, as we allow ourselves to ask questions, to read commentaries or Google what those passages mean, we can work out what this book is really all about. That it is about a God who longs to enter into a relationship with us. So where to start? Well, if you've never read the Bible before, I want to encourage you to start in the New Testament with the Gospel of Luke. It's one of the four eyewitnesses accounts, and Luke was actually a physician who started off life as a non-Jesus follower. But as he walked with Jesus, as he came across this guy, his life radically changed. And that's what he describes in his eyewitness account, the book of Luke. If you like to use this book as part of your worship, why not open it right bang on in the middle and find the book of Psalms? Those ancient worship songs that tell us a little bit more about how we can praise God, but also how we can be really honest and tell him about our struggles and our sorrows and our pain. If you like history, why not have a look at the book of Acts, again in the New Testament. It's again written by this guy called Luke, as he tells us a little bit more about the early church. And if you've read the book, the Bible, for a long time and you'd like to have a challenge, why not dig a little bit deeper into 1 and 2 Kings, 1 and 2 Chronicles, Exodus, Genesis, and tackle some of those more difficult passages? When I chat to people often, they find this book just really boring. They're very unimpressed with it because it seems to be such an ancient, irrelevant book. But today I want to challenge you, pick it up, read it again. Maybe on a daily basis, a couple of pages. Find a translation that's easy to understand and that you can relate to. And I believe that as you do that more regularly, you will actually find and you discover that the Bible is a lot more exciting, that the Bible is a lot more relevant and a lot more important than you first thought. So give it a go. Pick up the Bible and have a look what God is telling you through this ancient book.